Hello and welcome back to A Quaint Life. In this week's video, I took the camera around with me on a few separate days just to show different parts of my week. Parts I think really contribute to the idea of creating a comfortable home. There is nothing extraordinary in any of these things. However, I believe there is something beautiful about ordinary moments, in the things we do to make our homes our own, and the intention behind those actions. I hope you enjoy today's video and that it inspires you in your own home. This week, school has begun for us, and naturally, this throws off anything I need to get done around the house. I'm a little behind on a few things that need my attention. Watering the houseplants is something I easily get behind on. Mine are overgrown and needing to be restaked and even some repotted. But I don't have much time between lessons, so I can't manage to repot anything. So a good watering and restaking will have to do. This small buffet table was my grandmother's, and I feel so fortunate to have a few of her pieces in my home. She also used it for her linens and tableware as well, but on top I like to keep a few things for quick breakfast or snacks for school days. This week I grabbed fruit and croissants. I have a load of towels washing, so while I'm in the kitchen area, I decided to get rid of all the leftover bread I have saved. I have several random bread ends and leftover loaves that I save in the freezer. When I have enough, I like to dry them out in the oven and then pop them into a food processor to make breadcrumbs. Now that the towels are dried, I'm going to get these folded, and then it's time to clean the bathroom. Again. This summer, we took a small trip to the ocean, and we stayed at an Airbnb. My daughter kept commenting on the fluffy, extra-large, hotel-style white towels the Airbnb host had in the bathroom for us. So I decided to pick up some to have that experience at home. I have to say, they actually do make shower time feel more luxurious. It's incredible what little touches of luxury can do to our days. Thank you. mealtime is always special for me, not just because I enjoy cooking, but I think it's more of the opportunity to provide a form of comfort in a day, to create a bit of beauty by setting the table, or just lighting a candle. If you aren't used to setting your dinner table, I encourage you to try it just once. It can enhance even the most humblest of meals. I'm making mushroom risotto on this particular night. What I do for my risotto is I add butter or olive oil to the pot to heat, and then I brown the mushrooms with some sea salt and thyme. In another pot, I'm heating some homemade vegetable stock I made just the day before. When you make risotto, you want to make sure your stock is hot before adding it to the rice, which you add just one ladle at a time to. I stir the rice and mushrooms while the stock absorbs into the rice, then add another ladle, doing the same each time. I add a cup of fresh grated Parmesan after turning off the heat, and a little butter. To plate, I like to use white bowls and top it with a little more Parmesan. To the world, it might appear that I'm merely a woman cleaning her home or cooking yet another meal. That would be a correct assumption. However, at the same time, those that do this work know it is the intention behind these acts that make it so powerful. So yes, you may be watching a woman cleaning her home or cooking a meal, but you are also watching someone led by love, with the intention of creating a comforting space for others to enjoy. To live a life that blesses others is no small thing. And if you find yourself ever discouraged in your home, doing these ordinary tasks, might you remember your intention and the love behind it?